Welcome to the Spy Collection. Here is Anastasios and this is another episode in our series of Cellebrite devices for digital intelligence collection. In previous episodes, we talked about how the release of the UME-36 opened a whole new world to spy agencies using those devices. But that was really formalized with this, the UFED, Universal Forensics Extraction Device, which was nothing more than a slightly modified UME-36 to better suit the needs of law enforcement and intelligence agencies, as we read in the 2011 book iOS Forensic Analysis. The Cellebrite Universal Forensic Extraction Device, UFED, first started as a consumer product that was primarily used by cell phone providers to transfer user data from one phone to another. It was a service that was needed when an individual changed carriers or phones. Cellebrite then developed the UFED device. Similar to the commercial device, however, this version could not write to another phone. This was replaced by writing the data to a USB flash drive, SD card, or Windows computer. At a higher level, prior to the UFED Physical Pro, the UME-36 was not much different from the UFED. Having said that, here's one of those UFEDs, which, as you can immediately see, it's almost identical to the UME-36 that we presented before. Apart from the logo here, there is no obvious difference, just as the book mentioned. On the left side, we have the connectors for the source device, including USB and IR, which were added in the UME-24 version, as we've shown you in that video, as well as an SD card reader. And on the right side, we have the destination or target for the extracted data, as well as the power plug for it. This is the SIM and smart card reader. And here we have a few more connectors, primarily to connect the UFED to the computer. Looking at its backside, there is also this. This is a maintenance socket for Cellebrite to program and debug those devices, same as the one we've seen in UME-36. For instance, this one was manufactured as the Bravo 14 edition, but it was later upgraded to Bravo 15. Now let's have a look at its internals. That's the smart card reader. And here we have the Ethernet controller. From that side, you can also see the two IR modules for source and target respectively. Basically, if you've seen our UME-36 Pro video, you'll notice that it's an identical hardware design. It still relies on an Altera Max CPLD marked as UFED Bravo 15, as you can see here, and uses an Intel PXA27 processor. Since it's virtually identical to UME-36, we don't want to spend a lot of time on this. Here is a close-up of its main board. And here is the keypad and the LCD display. Putting everything back together and continuing with another UFED variant. This device had massive success in government agencies globally, and that literally changed the strategy of Cellebrite to focus primarily on the CELLEX space moving forward. One such upgrade was this. Remember, that was a Bravo 14 upgraded to Bravo 15. Well, this was a Bravo 15 upgraded to Bravo 16. A huge differentiating factor here is its protective rubber case, allowing government agents to use them in the field safely, as well as the addition of an embedded battery to allow government agents to use it with no need for an external power source. You can also see the dust covers all around it. This convenient stand and the battery it was coming with was a lithium polymer battery. Its manufacturing date, May of 2009, gives us a point in time for the UFED. Here is an overview of the Cellebrite devices we have covered so far and when they were introduced to give you a better perspective. Also, in case you wonder, the battery connector is here, and this is the on-off switch. And here is a button for the battery indicator. There is no reason to disassemble these two, as it's almost identical to this one. We want to remind you that the UME-36 Pro we presented some time ago was the Bravo 17 variant. That means this is Bravo 14-15, this is 15-16. The UME-36 Pro we've shown before is the 17, and this here is the Bravo 18 variant. Before we continue further, here's a leaked email from WikiLeaks that shows us how the Mexican government was using those at the time. The email was from the Mexican company Innovtech to the Italian company Hacking Team, which was offering exploitation tools to hack into mobile phones and install spyware for covert surveillance operations by spy agencies. This was from September 17, 2013, and as we read, "Hi Alejandro, as per our telephone conversation last Thursday, please allow me to introduce ourselves. We are a Mexican company dedicated to consulting and marketing security, intelligence and counterintelligence products and services. As I mentioned to you, we are interested in learning more about your products. We work with governments in various states like Yucatan, Tabasco, Guanajuato, Michoacán, Sinaloa y Tamaulipas. On this stage, we work directly with the governor's office and with the Ministry of Safety and the Attorney General. Our main projects have to do with the creation of the CTT, Telephone-Based Tactical Technology Center. The systems that we use are I2 Analyst Notebook, UFED Cellebrite, Location System of Mobiles in Real Time, Tactical Monitoring System and Cell Interception, GSM 3G, and Directional Finder, as well as services with local cellular telephone companies. Another project, we are partners with one of the most important companies of technology integration, Securitech, with the comprehensive projects of urban video surveillance and highway roads, besides the construction and implementation of the C4s 911 in the USA. It is our interest to get to know your Da Vinci remote control system with the purpose of selling it in the security areas of our government customers. Knowing its operation, scope and price, we can be contacted via telephone, email, or even attend a personal presentation. At the moment, we are registering on your website to receive information about the conferences you provide. Looking forward to your reply. Best regards, David, CEO." As mentioned, those UFED devices were becoming exceptionally popular among spy agencies since they made CELLEX incredibly simple, even for people with no prior technical expertise. If you recall the timeline we showed, the UME-36 was introduced in 2007, and here we showed that the B16 variant was likely from around 2009. The battery of this, the Bravo 18, also gives another date, April of 2011. Although those dates do not necessarily mean that they match the manufacturing of the entire unit, they do match nicely with the Cellebrite timeline and the models, so it's plausible that they are correct. And the latest UFED variant that we could find was this. That's the UFED Bravo 19. Its battery was manufactured in July of 2011. And here is another interesting leaked cable from WikiLeaks. This was from February 2, 2010, sent by the US Embassy in Costa Rica to the State Department in the US and the Group Destinations Bureau of Western Hemisphere Affairs. It was titled Costa Rica 2009 End Use Monitoring EUM Report. And we read that. 1. Per reference Alpha, Embassy San Jose provides the following information regarding EUM of resources acquired with U.S. Department of State, International Narcotics and Law Enforcement Affairs, INL, funds. And among others, we read that the U.S. government funded Costa Rica's Drug Control Police, or PCD, saying that in calendar year 2009, two additional CT30 kits and two Cellebrite UFED ruggedized portable systems were donated. The latter permits the user to extract data from cell phones and PDAs. In Costa Rica, it will be used for conducting criminal and counter-narcotics investigations on narco-trafficker cell phones and gather evidence for use in prosecution. With the Merida initiative, we expect U.S. Customs and Border Protection, CBP, to donate another 14 kits. From WikiLeaks, we can also find this brochure from the GovCon 6 conference, where Cellebrite had a booth. GovCon 6 took place on October 12, 2010, in Rich Carlton's Tyson's Corner in McLean, Virginia in the U.S., literally just 5.6 miles from the CIA headquarters, 16 miles from the NGA, 18 miles from the NRO, and so on. In other words, in the heart of the US spy agencies. Cellebrite's universal forensic extraction device, UFED, solution provides cell phone data extraction technology and forensic data analysis solutions for government agencies, military, corporate security and law enforcement entities. Agencies trust Cellebrite's UFED for fast, reliable and secure extraction of cell phone data, even if it has been deleted, enabling them to analyze and use this data more quickly and efficiently. Working in close cooperation with the world's premier carriers to receive the most up-to-date technology in the market, UFED supports nearly 2,500 mobile devices, including GPSs and satellite phones, the most comprehensive coverage available today. Although this first UFED from the Israeli Cellebrite didn't have significant differences with its commercial equivalent, the UME-36 Pro, this was about to change, and Cellebrite was about to enter deep into the spy world. Of course, those will be covered in future episodes of this series, but you can imagine that governments and militaries didn't stop with asking Cellebrite for portability with an embedded battery or more rugged construction. They asked for more, and Cellebrite delivered. Among them, one of the most controversial subjects to this day, giving militaries and governments a very easy means to hack into mobile devices without a need for technical expertise. More or less, we're getting closer to what modern CELLEX looks like, but all of that will be part of our next video in this series. In the meantime, we've seen how an Israeli company with a very innovative technology gradually started entering the spy world, which is a great and relatively recent example that nothing is as it seems.